good evening, everyone. Again, this is Alvy from Just Alvy News. Give you guys a few seconds to log on. I'll try to talk loud. I'm in Hensley, Arkansas, right out Sunshine Lane. When you do come on, click a care reaction on this one. I'm going to catch you up on the story that has been going on up here. We do have Charlotte on the way up here to examine the dog that's been involved. Here's what we know on the story. The owner of the piece of property out here noticed someone was on their property digging a hoe and was about to bury the dog alive. Says he's going to bury the dog on her property, and he said, "No, you're not." Then altercation kind of took place. We had the suspect's name and all that information. When the police got here, they went over to check on the dog. The dog began to raise his head up, and that's when they realized the dog was alive. The dog is in the ditch directly behind me. We do have him covered up out here. Does look like he might have a head injury. Definitely a terrible spot to his leg. We're seeing, we got Charlotte coming out to see if the dog will be able to be saved. It's just sad out here. So I did want to give y'all that heads up out here. I will tell you, I have a, now, sorry, I'm kind of eavesdropping, see if I can get more information. Now, before the police got here, the suspect involved did get into a vehicle, got picked off, and they did take off. So the police have not made contact with the suspect, but the person who made the call has provided us with a picture, his name, the car he got in, and information on that. Dug out in Hensley, Arkansas, if you're just here. A neighbor tried to bury a live dog in another neighbor's yard. The dog is still up and able to move around. Now, they did say the dog for a few minutes had its head up. By the time I got up here, the dog hasn't moved its head very much anymore. Initially talking to Charlotte over the phone, because of that, dog might have to be put down. We hope that's not the case. The dog has not lifted his head up. We will put his picture out there, description of the car. Doug, I do not believe the dog's going to be okay. The dog hasn't moved his leg. It's badly, badly injured. To me, it did look like the dog had a head wound. His eyes have gotten red, but the dog is still breathing, so I think there might be some internal injuries at this point. I don't know if any of y'all are emergency vets. If Charlotte does think the dog is saveable, she's a few minutes away here, we'll know. So just as soon as you know what, stories like this, like, even if your dog got hit by a car, have the courtesy of at least putting the dog out of its misery before you try to bury it alive. And then you don't want to even bury it in your own yard. You want to bury it in your neighbor's yard. So, it's probably Charlotte around there. You know, it really upsets me. The guy's name's Elliot. I'm going to have his picture. I'm going to tell you what car he's come in. It does look like Charlotte has arrived up here. I'm going to log off of here right now. That way I can talk to Charlotte. I will give you an update before we leave here. Just to recap now, we're waiting for Charlotte to get here to see if the dog that the neighbor was trying to bury alive will be able to be saved. Just as soon as I get home, I will have the suspect's picture and all of his information available for you. Say a prayer for those people, for real. This is Alvy from Just Alvy News. I'll be in a little bit. Always make good choices.